Welcome to Nashville, Tennessee, Music City, USA, and home to the Commodores of Vanderbilt, who hope today they will hit all of the right notes. We've got a sensational matchup for you. Fans have been five again and getting ready for this game, as we'll see a squad from the ACC, the SMU Mustangs, taking on a team from the SEC, the Vanderbilt Commodores. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollock and Jesse Palmer. Time to get this game started. Commodores will get us started with the opening kickoff. From inside his own 10, let's see what he gets. Able to find enough room to get it out across the 25, he's brought down at the 26. So SMU's offense takes the field for the first time today. Here he comes, and obviously defense is always going to be aware of a quarterback, but boy, he finds a way to put defenses on their heels all the time, David.
I mean, what can't he do? He's got the weapons, he's got the confidence, he's got the experience. Jesse, these kind of guys are so hard to defend.
You're right. They better be able to find a way to get pressure on him, because if they don't, this is going to be a long day.
Not what they had in mind to start this drive. Here comes second and 13. Wide out in motion. Leaves it with the back. Yeah, it's a bit of a surge, and he's knocked down after picking up three to the 26. Somebody needs to make a play here. It's third and long from the 26. From the gun, wants to pass. They're bringing heat. Makes the catch. It's Harris. Put it right on him. Sweet play. Good pickup, and they'll move the chains with the first down. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. The Mustangs with the first and 10. They'll try the run. At the 45 on his way. They wrestle him to the ground, but he's got plenty for a first down. And the Mustangs look to keep this drive humming. Comes out throwing on first down. A little release to the back. He's there to make the stop, and they threw it in reverse, losing yardage on that play. They'll run it out of the shotgun. And he has a solid gain before the defense bottles him up. If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. It's a draw. They are on the move as they pick up the first down. They'll spot it at the 28. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Wide receiver coming across in motion. They'll throw it on first down. Grab in the backfield. It's Harris. And he's able to shed one tackle and pick up pretty good yardage. The Mustangs have pushed it inside the 20. Here's the handoff. And he'll be taken down, but he does have enough for the first down.
It's not a flashy play call, but that is exactly what it was designed to do. Get 2 yards, get the first down.
Now inside the 20, first and 10 from the 18. He wants to throw. Makes the catch. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, SMU.
You love as a head coach to watch your offense take the field and establish a rhythm and consistency the way they did there. Everything they dialed up was working to perfection. They go 10 plays on the opening drive and cap it off with a touchdown.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point is good, and it's 7-0. They put together a 74-yard touchdown drive, and the finisher, an 18-yard touchdown throw. He'll return it. I know he thinks he can house every return, but sometimes you just have to take a knee as he's stopped at the 14. So Vanderbilt's offense will try to get something going with their first possession. As we take a look at our impact players for this game, David, what do you look for make an impact from your leaders.
Your leaders not only have to lead the football team, but they got to step up and make plays on the field, keep everybody calm. These guys typically do a really good job.
Yeah, David, and they also generally set the tone for their respective football teams, regardless of which side of the ball they play on.
Picked off! And he'll be marked down, but what a play to come up with that interception.
Not the start this kid was looking for. Very first pass of the day gets picked off. This is a defense that's got a lot of ball hawks on the back end, and he's got to be real careful with his eyes, not telegraph throws like he did right there. He's going to have to settle in.
Bunch formation trying to spring a guy free. They're going to open this drive with a pass. And the quarterback runs out of time, and down he goes at the 38.
You get five sacks in a game the way this defense did last week, and it's going to make your offensive coordinator second-guess himself a little bit with respect to protections. I'm not sure how confident this offense is early in the game because they've already given up a sack.
So now on second and long, you start to think just don't fall out of field goal range. He's looking to throw. Going for it all. And it's caught. Touchdown, Mustangs.
Man, this offense has started the season off so good. 1-0 a week ago, right? Now building on it again. Great job putting points on the board. It's still the first half, but this unit looks dialed in.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point makes it 14-0. Aggressive play calling on that drive. Just two plays, they get the long touchdown pass to pay it off. And no chance at a return. Here they'll start this drive at their own 25. Vanderbilt has the ball again, and here comes that Commodore offense. To say this has been a slow start is a bit of an understatement, and they really need to get it going here, Jesse.
That's right. The opponent, they're firing on all cylinders right out of the gate. Offensively for this unit, they've been slow and struggling. They need an explosive play to wake themselves up.
Yeah, and it's just the first quarter, so it's not the end of the world. You've seen slow starts, but you've got to continue to pick and pick and pick until you find that play or that scheme that you can use against this defense.
Might as well run him until they stop him. He's got it again. Pretty good effort on that one to work his way up to the 42. On second down, he'll let it fly. And the pass is incomplete thanks to a big hit. Come to the line at the 42, facing a third and short. From the gun, wants to pass. Let's it slip right through his hands, and it'll be fourth down after the rare drop from this dude. The Commodores decide to punt it away. Getting our first look of the afternoon at the punter. Fair catch called for and made. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. That last drive, really productive. David wound up with a touchdown. They'll try to do it again.
Yeah, so I don't expect this offense to change too much, Reese. They had a great drive. They got the touchdown. Everything working. I would expect them to keep pushing this ball downhill.
And just imagine if they could put another touchdown on the board right here. They could capture so much momentum in this game with back-to-back TDs.
He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three. On third and long, you'll need to push it downfield. Just a short pass to the tight end. And after the stop, that is going to put a bow on this first quarter. He gets a block. Good job by the coverage team, and that's how we'll end the period. That's the end of the period, and SMU has the lead. Really strong performance so far to be able to build a lead here in the first period as we look at the stats. This could be a pivotal moment in this game as we open the second period and they try to find a way to answer. Moving the running back, trying to get the D to tip its hand. And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short gain. After the 3-yard pickup, they come to the line second and 7. Caught in the backfield, it's Smith. They make the stop, not a whole lot of ground picked up there, and they'll have work to do to get the first down. How bold will they be on third down after that last run? He wants to throw it. Got it set up on the outside.
On the move at the 30.
They drag him down, but not before he's moved the chains and the screen pass is effective.
Phenomenal play call by the offensive coordinator. You're calling screen passes to take advantage of a good pass rush, and that's exactly what happened. The offensive linemen, they just let those defensive ends run up the field. Quarterback did a perfect job holding on to the ball to the last possible second, getting it out to his running back. And man, that running back had a convoy out ahead of him.
He's got it on the move. He's brought down, but there's a flag on the play. Let's see if it stands.
Hold it. Okay.
Amazing how many times an offensive holding penalty will stall a drive. Let's see if the offense can overcome it. Fires toward the end zone. And he's got it! Touchdown, North!
What a nice start for this offense. The throw game getting working, getting the touchdown pass. This quarterback getting a little bit of confidence. This passing game getting in a rhythm. Nice start for this offense.
Just a second. The official's going to take a second look at this one. And they take another look at the play, but the official's on the field. We're right, and the play will stand. And it's up and good as they draw just a touch closer. We check in with Kevin Connors. What's going on, Kevin?
A lot of eyeballs on your game, guys, and a few on this interesting matchup as well. North Carolina is putting on an offensive clinic. They've built a big lead, and this one is approaching blowout territory. They're up 14 over the Pandas. We've got our eye on things here and everything else going on right now, and any updates, we'll see them here, guys.
And how about that one? Kevin will be keeping an eye on everything going on elsewhere. Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. He's looking to throw. These two conferences largely share the same geographic footprint. The ACC loves it when they can take down a team from the SEC.
And we see these two conferences play each other oftentimes early in the season, late this season. David, think about Clemson, South Carolina, Florida, Florida State. These players have a lot of familiarity with one another.
And this already matters so much to these kids because they grew up in the same area a lot of times, like Reese was talking about with the footprint. But how about in the past, too? When your league, undefeated league champion gets left out of the playoff for an SEC team, a little more fuel for the fire.
They try to pop a run on the draw. They can rely on this guy to pick up solid yardage when they need it, and he's out to the 43. As they come to the line on third and short from the 43, I wonder if they already know they'll go for it if they don't make it here. Dragged down to the turf, but not before getting the first down. And the Mustangs have their offense in high gear. From the gun, the running back has it. A most efficient pickup of 6 on first down. It's second and 4. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. Tackled after picking up the first down. The Mustangs come to the line with a new set of downs. Wants to throw on first down. That's caught. It's Harris. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there. Trying to get a rhythm in the passing game. Now on second down. The give to the tailback. Discards a man.
Well, the offense is in a really nice rhythm right now. It seems like no matter what they're dialing up, they're getting positive yards. And it just feels so good as a play caller when you know on first down, you can get yards like that turning around and handling.
Yeah, and on the other side, you're scratching your head going, what the heck can I do here? You got to find something. The defense has got to find a way to create some momentum. Whatever they're doing right now, it's not working. So you got to keep going through that play sheet and maybe find something a little bit different that can give this offense something to think about.
Able to get just a few before sliding to avoid the hit. On third and short, they'll try to throw for it. Touchdown, SMU! And they made it to the house when they found that 6 points waiting on them. Effective offense leading the way here in establishing this lead.
And that's how you draw it up, right? You want to come out, be clicking early, get everything going. Want to get all the facets rolled. The defense right now on their heels. They have no answers. The offense doing whatever they want.
Lining up to add another. And the extra point puts them on top 21-7. Precise, relentless execution on that 13-play scoring drive. And the score comes on a 17-yard throw for the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the five. And the returner will be knocked down. Vanderbilt has it back and heading out to go on the attack. Not a lot of time left here in the half. Let's see if they can cut into this lead.
And this drive isn't a must score, but man, you look at the scoreboard. You're down two scores. Jesse, you got a good opportunity to create some momentum, cut it to a one-score game. This is an important possession.
Yeah, it's important to create that momentum now, David, too, and not wait to get it going here at the start of the third quarter.
They get enough rush, and it pays off. The sack at the 20.
One of the things I love about this defense is they're so versatile in the ways they can get after the quarterback. In their last game, they came away with 5 sacks, came from all over the place. They got the win. So you know in this one, they're going to dial up a lot of different looks. It's going to be tougher this offense try to keep their quarterback standing up straight.
So now they're staring at a second and long from their 20. He's looking to throw. He'll lob one deep down the left side. It's complete. A huge pickup. Open runway ahead. Touchdown, Vandy. And once he found open space, the band might as well start playing.
This coaching staff was trying to identify playmakers on offense early this year. How about the start of the season this guy has had? Scored in their first game, scored early in this one. Defenses up to this point don't have any answers for this guy.
He'll try to tack on one more. And with the extra point, every little bit counts as they get closer. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. The way this game started, you feel as if you have to score a touchdown every time you have it, and now we'll see if they can respond.
Yeah, and I wonder how much pressure that puts on the offense. Jesse, like, you know this is back and forth, and I got to score, and every possession matters so much. What does that do to you as a quarterback?
Well, it puts a lot more pressure on you for sure to feel like I got to make every third down throw. If guys are open vertically down the field, I got to hit them too. We can't let our serve get broken.
And this junior quarterback shows you why the scouts love that big arm of his. Going up top on first down. And he got smacked just as he released the pass. It's incomplete. After the misfire, it's second down. He's looking to throw. Bought a little time, lets it go. It's complete. Ball is at the 42-yard line, close to four down territory. Here's third and short. Quickly complete. And how about that catch and run? So dangerous, this guy. The offense calls timeout. It's the second one they've used this half. And the Mustangs have it with a first and 10. He's going to pass. The quarterback can make a big play when he starts moving around. Got to protect the merchandise. Gets down without taking a hit. The offense will quickly use the timeout. Line getting set on second down. He's looking to throw. And they needed a little more room to work with as that one sails out of bounds. They couldn't make the connection on second down. Now a third and 7 to keep the drive alive. They're trying to get to it. Pressure is effective from the defense.
this guy's notched a sack starting to be a problem. A guy that's diagnosing passes, rushing the passer really, really well. This defense could use this guy's production consistently.
No return coming. He'll call for the fair catch. First half in the books. Time now to join Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Guys, a stirring start to things today in Nashville as we say hello from our broadcast studios. And we have to start this halftime breakdown by addressing the play of this elite wide receiver. This is clearly a young man who, once he's finished playing on Saturdays, he's going to be playing on Sundays. The kid has different gears. He has a knack for finding gaps in the defense. And I can't remember a college player with that kind of catch radius. And with that, let's send it back to the guys at First Bank Stadium.
The Mustangs will kick it off to start the second half. From inside the 10, here he comes. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Vanderbilt has the ball again, and here comes that Commodore offense. He wastes no time and comes out throwing. That's caught. It's Fowler. They make the stop right there. Good pickup. It's still short of the first down. Quick handoff. They get him on the ground, but it's a first down. They'll snap this one from the 32. It's first down. To the ground. He's got it again. Got behind those pads and picked up three out to the 35. Got three on first down at second and 7. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And they drag him down, but not before he picks up the first down. And the Commodores are moving quickly down the field. Quarterback changing the plays at the line. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. They'll go to the ground. A strong tackle and wrap up from the junior. Now facing a third and long. From the gun, wants to pass. He'll take the deep shot. And they can't hook up on the big play, and that brings up a fourth down. The Commodores will punt this one away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. Not going to risk a return here. He'll make the fair catch. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. They'll have another opportunity to extend this lead after punting last time, David.
And it's important to put that punt behind you. It's over. Let it go. Get back to what you were doing that built this lead.
Yeah, and defense, obviously, they won a few downs that last drive, so we got to put them on their heels here. Maybe mix up a few personnel groupings and try to show them some pictures they haven't seen.
He is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose yards on that one. Third and long, and he'll try to throw for it. He lets one fly deep, makes the grab, and they'll finally bring him down after he rips off a huge play.
A defense, I got to find a way to get some more pressure on the quarterback or disrupt their timing and their rhythm. I can't give them these big chunk plays through the air. I got to be maybe a little bit more aggressive or do something a little bit different.
Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. Some really tough running there gets him to the 45-yard line. Halfway there on first down, it's second and 5. Play action. Gets it out quickly. He's close to the first down, but they're going to mark him just a little short. Let's see what they do on third down. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. They were all over him. Nowhere to go as that third down play turned into a disaster. Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. He'll call for the fair catch here. Vanderbilt has it back and heading out to go on the attack. They just didn't quite find the rhythm on that last drive, Jesse. They had to punt it.
I think they got to be more physical, David. I think up front they got to do a better job getting blocks and establishing this running game.
And how easy does football become if you're the more physical team? If you can threaten the run and then run play action, it opens up the whole offense at your disposal.
Man down on the play as the officials take a break to let him be checked out. They've got it at the 37. It's first and 10. Grabbed behind the line. It's Fowler. And how about the efficiency on that one? It'll bring up second and 4. Went with the running game on first down, now back at it. They'll put the tight end in motion. The give is to Smith. Look out, he's got room. Got a lot of running room. Ripped off a huge shot play on that one. He gets the first down before he steps out of bounds. And the Commodores come to the line with a fresh set of downs. A little pre-snap eye candy for the defense.
And a nice job by the running back, finding space, getting downhill, making a good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
Big catches, big plays, tons of yards through three quarters for these two guys. Is the scoreboard on their side, but so too is time as we open the fourth. Caught in the backfield, it's Fowler. They'll get it down to the 8-yard line on that throwing catch, and the defense is backed up against the wall. With the run on first and goal. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. The run up the middle here, looking for a path to the end zone. Brought down at the 7 after picking up 3. A touchdown here on third and goal really ratchets up the game pressure. From the gun, wants to pass. Now he's going to break the pocket. And he's sprinting, he'll take it all the way. Touchdown, Vanderbilt. Well, that didn't necessarily go as planned, but it was most effective in the end.
I love it, Reese. Down in the red zone, this quarterback didn't have anybody open. Didn't panic. He just decided, man, I'm going to go do this myself. I'm going to use my wheels and put up 6 on the board. He did just that.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. Point was good, and we are deadlocked here in the fourth. And for a quick update, let's go to Kevin Connors in the studio.
All right, guys, a little update on what else is happening in college football this weekend. Duke is ahead in this one, but unlike the days of Daniel Jones, this offense is not guaranteed to just keep scoring points today. They're up by a field goal over TCU. We are the eyes and ears of the college football fan, and we've got you covered all day here in studio, guys.
Oh, and how about that? I know Kevin and those guys will be keeping an eye on it for us. Might as well stick with him. Finds a little bit of space, gets 3 to the 22. They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. It's a draw. And the defense is swarming to keep him from getting to the first down. And the Mustangs will try to pin them back with the punt. He's getting a lot of work. Fourth time he's punted tonight. And they'll bring him down to get the offense started on the next drive. Vanderbilt has it back and heading out to go on the attack. This could be a real turning point in the game. They scored a touchdown. They got a stop. And now, and this will be picked off. A costly turnover in a tie game. Didn't really have room to operate on the return, but he hands him the ball at the 32.
I get it. It's the fourth quarter. It's a tie game. I need to go out and make a play offensively. But I tell you what, I'm going to be on the sideline now after that interception. As a quarterback, I'm like, please, defense, please go out there and bail me out. Give me another opportunity to go take the lead and win this ball game.
We'll see the offense make its way onto the field here, hoping for a successful drive. Off play action on first down. Got his man on the right. And that was some kind of collision between a couple of big bodies there, and he stopped from getting the first down. He's looking for an open man on second down. Trying to buy a little time, and he cannot, but he does get it back closer to the line of scrimmage.
Good news is they didn't lose a ton of yards. The bad news is that's the third sack they've given up now in this game. They have got to do a better job protecting this quarterback.
Third down conversions are a huge stat, and this one would be a doozy if they can pull it off. From the gun, wants to pass. Didn't have much of a choice, just had to throw that one away. It'll be fourth down. The Mustangs will send out the punt unit. They may have to pay him overtime. He's punting for the fifth time today. Makes a move. Turns like that are why you don't settle for the fair catch if you don't have to. Picks up just a little bit of yards to help out the O. Vanderbilt has the ball again, and here comes that Commodore offense. Well, let's see if this drive goes better than the last one. They were in and out quickly after the quick pick, David.
Yeah, first play, big mistake, man. Now, let's get this offense in a little bit of a rhythm, maybe before you open it up again, Palmer, or do you trust him right away?
He seems to me like the guy maybe that just needs to kind of get into the flow of the game. So maybe you get the running game going here, just give him some easy looks to let him get loaded up.
A touch out of field goal range. They need to pick up yards quickly on third down.
Encroachment, defense.
Contact in the neutral zone leads to that penalty. Good news for the offense. From the gun, he'll try to throw for it on third down. Grab near the marker. It's Barrett. He gets the job done on third down. They move the chains. It's at the 37. The Commodores will have it first and 10. Smith takes the handoff. They'll pick up four, second and six coming. Stuck with a running game on first down. Now here they come again. Out of the gun, they give to the back. Bulls his way forward. They get him stopped after a pickup of five to the 28. The clock stops as we have reached the final 2 minutes of the game. They'll snap it from the 28 in field goal range, but it's third and short. Just outside the red zone as they pick up the first down, they'll spot it at the 22. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. The offense down to the 22 on first and 10. Give to the running back. A 7-yard pickup. It'll be second and 3. And the Commodores have pushed it inside the 20. One man in the backfield, and he gets it. They get him on the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down. And as time is dwindling away in this one, the offense is set up. First and goal, a great opportunity to get the go-ahead score. He steps and powers and works his way. They finally get him down at the 2. The defense going to stop the clock with a timeout. They want to make sure they have everybody on the same page. Trying to slam in. He works his way ever closer all the way down to the 1-yard line.
Yeah, and I tell you what, I love the run game down here. I love being able to give it to a back and be able to trust him. Listen, he didn't have any touchdowns on the season, so I know he's wanting to punch one in. And down here, giving me the opportunity. Let me prove myself.
Touchdown, Commodores! And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the fourth.
Man, how about this offense in crunch time, doing what they do, getting six on the board. Now I turn to my defense right now and say, boys, we need one more stop. Go out there, give me one more.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. The extra inside the 10-yard line, he'll bring it back. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. They'll come out on this drive and let it rip. On target over the middle. And it is a chunk play, a huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end. One big play to get it up near midfield. Now they're in business at the 47. To the air on first down. Oh, he drops the football. He had him right down the gut of the field. Instead, it'll be second down. Couldn't connect on first down. Now back to the air. Makes the grab over the middle. Tackled, but he has a first down. Man down on the play as the officials take a break to let him be checked out. Most important part of a clutch drive, piece together some first downs, get in position, and here they are on first and 10. Looking to move it through the air, using the quick game, and a good job of coverage by that defense, just a short pickup. Everybody has to be set. They have to get it off. Looking to throw on second down. He unleashes a long one. And they wanted it all on that incomplete pass. Instead, they're looking at third down. They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down. And they'll spike the ball to try to save as much time as they can. Here comes the offense on second down. He's looking to throw. He's got the tight end. We've got a timeout on the field, a tight game in the fourth, and the brain trust will go to work. He'll throw on third down. Oh, they really could have used that catch there. Physical pass defense. It brings up a fourth down. They'll try it on the ground. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup. They kept that drive alive, but still ground to cover here on first down. Can the defense stop them again on second and goal? He'll run it up the middle, trying to pick his way to the end zone. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three. And they got to the line expeditiously, spiked it, and stopped the clock. And this could prove to be the biggest play of the game. They'll go for it on fourth and goal. They want to throw it. Fires into the end zone. And the pass is intercepted. And he's brought down, and his defense gets the ball back for his own.
Big-time players make big-time plays, big-time games. Great job by the defense. Not closing the door completely, but stopping the momentum late in the game. You already got a lead. Nice job, D.
Trying to create some confusion. So with the late lead, they're ready to just drain the clock in victory formation. And the quarterback takes the snap and kneels down. Winning can become a habit. Now they've won back-to-back games and probably building a little confidence.
And you want it to be a habit. That's what you talk about as a coach week after week. Let's build. Let's create momentum and continue to build on it. And then you look up at the end of the season, you never know where you could be, what dreams you could bring to reality.
At the end of the day, I think good teams find ways to win games. And over these last two games, it hasn't always been easy. They've had to overcome some adversity, but at the end of the day, they were able to step up, make the plays necessary, and do that. Very, very impressive.
That's going to do it for us. For Jesse Palmer, David.